And everyone, I'm Stephanie Gorin.
And I'm Bridget Shanahan. George is off tonight. Vermont State Hospital is no more. That today from Governor Shumlin, nearly 2 months after Irene hit the hospital hard.
New at 6. News Channel 5's Jill Gladen is live in Waterbury with the latest. Hi, Jill.
Hi, well, we're live here at the state hospital. There's no one here because, as you said, Irene caused evacuations and major damage here. You can see behind me, though, someone has put up a sign here that says, thank you, VSH patients and staff. We learned from the governor, though, today that they will not be coming back.
So it is my intention never to go back to Waterbury for the state hospital.
Governor Peter Shumlin made himself clear. The Vermont State Hospital in Waterbury is officially no more.
We've been meeting on this every other day, it seems, since Irene hit.
The aging facility dedicated to the care of severe mental illness stands unusable after it took a major hit from Irene. 50 patients had to be evacuated, and that came after years of questions over the hospital's future.
It is old, it is decrepit, and as I've said before, if you put me in there as a patient without being depressed, I would be extraordinarily depressed if you left me there for 30 days.
Patients have been in other facilities and hospitals since the storm. Shumlin detailed a new plan to revamp care without a main hospital to go back to. The plan opens 14 beds at the Brattleboro Retreat for permanent long-term care. It also calls for another facility to house 15 beds. Talks are underway at the Pine Ridge School in Williston as a possibility. The plan also calls for more wraparound services at state agencies to avoid hospitalization, plus two new step-down facilities to do the same.
We had come to the conclusion that about half of the people there were there because they couldn't find an alternative setting.
It's a plan that could save taxpayers $10 million a year in hospital upkeep, Shumlin said. But asked about the more than 200 employees that worked there, he gave no definite plan.
We are going to utilize the state employees wherever they can be used.
Well, Shumlin did not rule out the possibility of a new facility sometime in the future. He did say, though, that he wants to see how this plan works before anyone talks about rebuilding. Stephanie?
All right, so Jill, now that we know the plan, what about the people living and working in Waterbury? How are they taking this news?
Well, it wasn't a complete curveball. They have been talking about the future of this hospital for a long time, but businesses say it still hurts, and that's especially after all that has happened with Irene.
We will definitely lose some customers. We have some very good customers that come from the state hospital. It won't affect us as much as not having the whole complex here.
Well, that's the big concern. We've heard a lot from people in Waterbury who are just scared that this complex is not going to be up and running the way that it used to be, and it is such a vital part of downtown Waterbury. Coming up tonight on NatCast, we'll have much more with reaction to this news. Live in Waterbury, Jill Glavin, News Channel 5.
All right, Jill.